there, Stampers. It's Jackie Bolhuis from Klompen Stampers. Today, we're going to make our own designer series paper. You know, you see me use designer series paper a lot. Stampin' Up! Has beautiful paper. But you know what? Sometimes it's fun to kind of do it the old-fashioned way and stamp your own. I remember years ago, we used to do that all the time. We'd take stamps and randomly stamp to make our own quote-unquote designer series paper. So we're going to do that today with kind of a one sheet wonder idea. Simple from the one sheet wonder perspective is one sheet, we're going to end up cutting it to make four cards by just adding a nice big bold greeting on it. So it's quick and easy. Perfect way if you need to make a whole bunch of like thank you cards or kind of mass produce a bunch of things. This will be a fun way to do it. And it's super simple. Those of you that are new to card making or don't have a lot of supplies, this is a perfect idea to use really with any stamps and greetings that you may have. So kind of a lot going on. Quickly before we flip the camera, thanks for watching me today. If you're brand new to watching me, make sure you subscribe. I usually do two videos a week, quick and easy card making and ideas. And those of you that return video after video, thank you so much. I love seeing your comments and just knowing that you enjoy the projects that I share. So leave me a comment. Let me know what you think of today's project. And then finally, all the details and all the supplies I use today will be over on my blog. I have it nice and easy. My website's klompenstampers.com, but the blog portion of it, there will be a link to the specific post in the description of the video. It should be like right down there in the video description, depending on the device that you're watching on. And that's where you can find all the details. So without further ado, let's flip it over and let's start stamping. Hold on 1 second. The stamp set that I'm using today is artistically inked. Now this stamp set has so many possibilities and I know you're going to see me use it a lot over the coming months. It does have coordinating dies, but today we're just going to use the images in it. And then we're going to grab some greetings from this new greeting set called Sunny Sentiments. So like I said, we're going to make our own designer series paper. So I have a piece here. It's actually 9.5 by 6.5. So I've cut it down a little bit for starters. Let's get the right colors here. And we're going to start by using the smaller flower in one. Well, not smaller one, not the great big one. But what I want to do is stamp this on scrap paper first. And then I'm going to stamp it on here 2 times. So always scrap paper, stamp, stamp. Now the reason for that is I wanted my colors a little bit lighter than what it is from straight off the ink pad. And you'll see why here when we get done. Let's see. And notice how I'm just spinning my cardstock around. Let's see, I want a lighter one there. So I'm going twice on scrap paper. Well, see, that's what I didn't want to do. Happens every time. That's okay. We'll make it work, right? So we've just kind of filled this in. And notice I was spinning that cardstock around because it just makes it easier to do random stamping that way because I want to kind of get images going every which way here. So for our leaf, we'll do the same thing. Scrap paper, and then we're going to always go 1, 2. And sometimes we'll even go like 3, 4 on there. But again, trying to get in the habit here and the rhythm. Oh, I think that one I didn't stamp off. You know, I get going and I start to talk and then I don't pay attention to what I'm doing. But again, just hit that scrap paper first and we're just spinning this all over here. You know, we're trying to fill this in as much as we can. The end goal is to have this paper like hardly any white space because we want to, remember we're making believe it's designer series paper. So let's see, let's get some green going in there. That little guy doesn't have any leaves. I think they all have leaves, right? So we can come back and put more green in here if we have to. But let's stop with that and grab a different stamp. So we've got Fresh Freesia. Now I think this color is light enough that we're gonna just go straight off our pad. Makes it so much easier. And again, I'm spinning this so those little flowers kind of look like they're going different ways. Make sure with random stamping, especially for the idea that I'm sharing with you today, that you run images off the side. Okay, off those edges, because we don't want that stamping to be all nice and neat in the middle. So we've done those. We're just kind of playing with some of these new colors. So this is the pale papaya. And again, I think it's going to be light enough. And with this one, we're really just now catching all that white space. So wherever you can squeeze these in, if some of those images go on top of each other, that's totally okay. There's nothing wrong with that. Let's get some of these on the edge. You want to just, you know, kind of sneak one in there, fill in those edges really well. I think we're looking pretty good there. Again, the whole idea was just to fill this up. I'm thinking, let's go ahead and put just a few dots. I think I'm going to use the green, and I'm stamping off again. But you can see how now I'm really filling it in. Now, once you're done with this, you could, you know, we're thinking of this as a piece of designer series paper. So you could cut this up and use it however you want on your cards. So let's see, got a rhythm going here. Can you hear that tap, tap, boom? Okay, I think, you know, you could sit here and you could play forever, but we're gonna call it good. Let's set those aside and let me grab my paper cutter. So I want to cut this into four pieces now. So we were at 9.5, so that is gonna make it 4¾. Hopefully I did my math right there. And then when I flip it this way, we'll cut it at 3¼. Now again, these measurements will be over on that blog post, so go ahead and look for that if you like this idea and want to copy this idea. And again, these stamps are gorgeous. I love these. But remember, this idea would be perfect for any stamps, okay? We just don't want them super dark, you know, your ink super dark on there, because what we're going to do is before we finish these on a card, we are going to take our greetings here. And like I said, these are from the Sunny Sentiments. And I am going to stamp our greeting on top of all of our stamping. There you go. See how that black just really pops? And we can go both directions here. But this is where if those colors were too dark, you wouldn't see the black. You wouldn't see our greeting. So that's why we want to make sure that we stamp those off or use colors that are a lot lighter to start with. Let's see, we'll do one of each going each way. How's that? There we go. So there are our four pieces. And then all we're going to do is adhere these onto our note cards. I love using note cards to make cards with because these come in a pack of 20. And you get the note cards all pre-scored for you, as well as the envelopes. So it makes it super easy just to whip out some cards. So we can go ahead and glue these all on. Like I said, great simple idea today for if you need to mass produce things. You know, here we made four cards in less than 5 minutes, I'm thinking. And it took me longer than it would otherwise just because I was talking. Look, there's our dark pink. It made it. We don't see it, or it doesn't get in the way of our greeting, because that's one that definitely would, our black might not show up so good on it. So let's go ahead and stick that there. And there we go. Just like that, we have four note cards ready to pop in the mail to someone. So I hope you like this idea. Super simple. Again, any colors, lighter colored ink, or stamp off on scrap paper first. Cut that 9.5 by 6.5 down to 4¾ by 3¼. And there you go. So hope you like it. Again, if you have any questions, make sure to reach out to me, leave me a comment, send me an email. I'm here to answer all your stamping questions. If you like a Stampin' Up! Catalog and don't already have a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator, you can request one over on my website. I'd be happy to pop it in the mail to you. So leave me a comment, let me know what you think, and I will talk to you again soon. Have a stamp happy day.